Hey guys, let's talk a bit about the euro versus the dollar. The precious hit a new multi-year high despite, you know, the overbought conditions cited by many retail traders as a reason for the price not going higher. Now, the reason for price pushing up higher, as you probably know, it looks like the Democrats won the two Senate seats. That's going to allow President Joe Biden, when he takes office later this month, to push forward with probably more stimulus. And that, as we know, when you print more dollars, when you bring more dollars into the system, tends to lead to a weaker currency. And that's the reason why we're trading higher here. Now, is it time to buy it right here at these levels? No, I don't think so. So let's talk a little about that. And let's also talk a bit about the GBP versus the USD. All right, so this is the EURUSD, and you're looking at a four-hour chart. And the price is right now at 123.37, as you can see here. And, you know, we started out with a bit of a sell-off in 2021, and then we pushed upwards, and then we pushed lower. Now, in GBP versus the USD, we nailed that entry and bounced perfectly. Here, we didn't actually go low enough for the price to reach the levels I wanted to be bullish from. But because the price has now traded to a new multi-high and taken out these levels, now in a position where we can reduce the trend of finding level. So the new trend of finding level I'm watching for the EURUSD is going to be 121.70. And I think if we go back to something like 122.78, which is a bit of a, almost like a 50% correction of the slide, then I think people are going to go back and buying again. Now, if you flip into something like smaller, like a 30-minute or even a 50-minute chart, you can actually see that we're dealing with a small ascending triangle here. So the break to 123.09 triggered that triangle, and it's telling us that pretty much we can gain with about 107 pip or so, 104 from that breakout point, which would take us up to something like as high as something like 123.90, 124, and that's really what I'm aiming for. As well, if you're curious to learn about this specific indicator here, it's called the ATFX support and resistance indicator. You can actually download and try it for free with an ATFX demo account or a real account, and I'll put that into the comment section, the first comment there, so you can download it and check it out. This is the GBP versus the USD, and GBP versus the USD maintains a bullish bias here as well. Like, with the help of the support and resistance indicator, we're saying that people were probably going to be buying around these lows down here. And surely they did. They bought around the 135.55 level, and then the market trade higher. Someone could have traded this in this way. So I'm going to show you how that would have been looked like. So you can see here how we pretty much bought around here at 135.56 and then got out earlier today around 136.65. And I think we will continue to trade upwards. There's no question about that. We are dealing with an uptrend. And the support and resistance indicator is pretty much telling us that people are probably going to be looking to get involved between 135.92 and the stop level, which is 134.61. I don't know exactly. Last time it bounced perfectly from the buy area, but I think from these levels, we should hopefully be okay. And if we manage to trade upwards, trade above take profit too, then this low is going to be the new trend defining level. And with that, guys, we're going to wrap things up. If you do have any questions for me, just leave them in the comment box. As well, don't forget to download your copy of the ATFX support and resistance indicator. See you guys soon. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to like the video. Thank you and bye.